Now the transaction is on 20th, cash paid to Pramod, cash paid to Pramod. So the two accounts are cash and Pramod. So Pramod is personal account and the business is paying cash to Pramod means Pramod is the receiver. So the rule of debit the receiver, we apply for Pramod and debit his account. So Pramod's account debit. Now cash is going out of the business. So credit what goes out, the real account rule we apply and credit cash. So two cash account and the amount is 6,000. The amount is 6,000. Your narration would be being cash paid to Pramod. Now the next transaction is on 22nd. It states that returned goods to Radhika. Returned goods to Radhika. So who was, if you see the previous transactions, we purchased goods from Radhika. We purchased goods from Radhika. So maybe because of some problem, we are returning some portion of goods to her. So the two accounts involved here are Radhika and goods are involved. Which goods are these? Purchased goods. So we will say purchase returns. For the goods, we use the word purchases returns. So this purchases returns word is nothing but it is representing goods. Goods are real account. So when we are returning, they are going out because they are purchased goods and we are returning, we are using the word purchase returns. So real account rule for goods you apply, goods are going out, so credit word goes out and therefore we are crediting purchases returns. Now Radhika, you apply the rule of personal account and see when we are, the business is returning the goods to Radhika, Radhika becomes receiver, so debit the receiver, as a result we are debiting Radhika's account. So the journal entry being Radhika account debit to purchase returns account and the amount is 2000. Your narration could be being purchase returns to Radhika.